Hello, good evening. The student from the class of 694 Nanoscale Computations and Simulations. So today I'm going to talk about the homework in NumPy library in Python. So we have just only two problems. The first one, so there are two point charts of a chart of E and minus 2E. At the Cartesian coordinates of 3, 2, and then 1, minus 3, respectively. So calculate the distance between the two charges, then the total electrostatic potential, and then the force acting on the two charges. So in order to do this problem, I have to explain more in detail. So let me share my screen. Okay. Okay. For the first problem, we have the two point charge. Okay. It is in the Cartesian coordinate, right? So let's draw a Cartesian coordinate like that. So this is X and this is Y. And the first one is at 3, 2 nanometers. So let's go to 1, 2, 3, 3 nanometers. And then 1, 2, 3, 2 nanometers. It is like that. And the second one is at 1, -3. So it is 1 and then -1, -2, -3, -3 nanometers. So this is the second charge. So the first charge is here and the second charge is there. Oops, sorry. Okay. And the first charge has the charge of plus E and the second one has the charge of minus 2E. Okay. First, to calculate the distance is really, is quite easy. First, you have to have the position vector of each charge. So let's say this charge has the position vector of R1. Okay. This R1 will be just a vector of 3 nanometers and then 2 nanometers. Okay. And another one is the position vector R2. And this one, the position vector will be just 1 nanometer and then -3 nanometers. Okay. So now, what do we need to do is that we need to find the vector R12, which is pointing from point 1 to point 2 here. R12 will be the vector of R2 minus R1. And the distance of between the charge 1 and the charge 2 is just the magnitude of the vector R2 minus R1. Okay. You might, in case that you are not remember, you do not remember, suppose that I have a vector which is like Rx in the x direction plus Ry in the y directions plus Rc in the c directions. The magnitude of vector is just the Rx squared plus Ry squared and then plus Rc squared and then square roots of those summation. So the first one, the distance between two charges is quite easy. Now, what you need to calculate is the total electrostatic potential. The electrostatic potential, or I will give it to be UE, equal to 1/4 pi epsilon naught. Of the charge 1, charge 2, over that distance between the two charges. So you already calculate the distance from the first problem here. So what you need now is just to put the number in this and then you will be done. I think this is quite easy as well. But for the third one, now we would like to calculate the force acting on the chart of minus 2. Force on the charge of minus 2e. Okay, is the force here? So the force between the chart 1 and chart 2 will point in this direction. So I will give this to be the unit vector r12. Okay. So the force is a vector, so it has to have both magnitude and then the direction. Force, let's say, is the force acting from the chart 1 to chart 2 equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught. And then it's going to be q1, q2, and then it's going to be r12 square in the direction of r12. Okay, this is the force, right? So the force will be in this direction. This is the force 1, 2, right? But so how do we calculate this unit vector r12? We can use this relation. The unit vector r12 equal to the vector r12 divided by the magnitude of the vector r12. So in this case, we're going to have the force acting from the chart 1 to the chart 2 equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, q1, q2, and then it's going to be r12 vector over r12 to the third. And this is the way we calculate the force as a vector. So here, the vector r12 will make this force to be a vector. And that is for the first problem. Okay, let's go to the second problem. The second problem. So this is the first one. For the second one, I say there is 8 ions with a chart of E sitting on the corner of the cubic box of the length 1.5 nanometer. So we have a box. We have this cubic box like that. We have this cubic box like that. And okay, so we have 8.8 ions. So here are the 8 ions at the corner of the box. Like that. And like that. And all the ions here have the charge of E. So this is quite simple. So in order to set up this, in order to calculate the total electrostatic potential, so in this problem, we have to calculate the E total electrostatic potential. We can calculate that by saying, okay, let's say this is chart Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, and then let's say this is Q5, Q6, Q7, and then this is Q8. Okay, so we can do just like this. We can do like 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, Q1, Q2, and then the distance between the chart 1, 2, plus 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, Q1, and then Q3, and then the distance between the chart 1, 3, so on and so forth, until we go to the chart 2. For the chart 2, we start from 4 pi epsilon naught. Here, we do not sum the electrostatic potential of the chart 2-1 because it will be the same as this one. So we will cut this out. We cannot calculate the chart the potential of a chart with itself. So we will cut this out as well. So it will start from Q2-3, and then the direction of chart 2-3. And then it will be 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, Q2, 4, Q2 and Q4, R2, 4, so on and so forth. And then it will be 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught. And then it will be Q3, Q4 over R3, 4, so on and so forth. So there will be a lot of pair. Oh, that's quite a loud noise. So there will be a lot of pair to calculate, but we can write this in a compact form. The total electrostatic potential in this case is going to be sigma I equal from 1 to n, in this case n equal to 8, and then sigma j, the charge j, that is higher than I to n equal 8. In this case, it's going to be 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, and then qi qj, and then with the direction from rij, quite easy, right? And because in this equation, in this problem, all the charge have the same, like all the ion have the same value of charge of E, so that we can take everything else from out of the summation signs. So it can be E square, and then 4 pi epsilon naught, and then sum I equal to 1, equal from 1 to n equal to 8, and then sum j that is higher than I, and then it's just the distance rij. It's quite easy, right? So here is how we solve the second problem of the homework. If you have any question, please let me know. Thank you, bye bye, and good luck.